Back again. So, to answer your question, which I just listened now again, when to know what to follow and what not to follow. I think the whole work is going beyond that. I don't know. I don't like this beyond because this is some kind of judgment or scales of values. But when do I get excited or when my mind is going to is in alert that something here is going on that I've never seen before or I've never heard before. And saying this never seen, never heard or never thought before doesn't mean something out of the blue, doesn't mean something. This is big cliche of improvising people for non-improvisers or people far from this world is that something is coming directly from the sky through you, and this is something totally new that never happened before. It is exactly the opposite. It is the same exact thing that everybody knows that happens a total different way. And sometimes a total different way is not even something spectacular, or it is just a tiny small difference that makes the whole thing look totally different. I don't know if you take a parallel with actors, for example, like there's many ways to act, there's as many ways as people, actors, actress, but sometimes like one actor as a very or actress as a very special, unique way to do something very banal, very, I don't know, like say like how Marcello Mastroianni would take a coffee in the morning, and he would have a way that no one else ever had this way. And maybe this is looking, and the reason I'm saying this because it's attaching the answer, the question to someone is part of the work is knowing who you are, which means knowing who you're not. And from there, this is where the complexity of acceptance of all this is coming. It is accepting who you are and how you make the difference. And this all improvising work is letting, making all the possibility happen that something else comes. Is that clear? I don't think it's very clear, but so therefore, again, it is this reason why you work like this, like doing every day the same. Because you'll be able to see, and because it's again like making oil. It's those very repetitive, tiny movements that open something. So all this practice that allows you not to think of what you're doing, they are doubled with this expecting something comes out of this that will put your mind on halt, on alert, and make you want to grab this because you don't know what it is, but not because you want to control it, but because here is something. Again, we are touching all those areas which are never very far. Religion is a big organization of this, but for political and power reasons. With art, it's touching this and making it an extra possibility. A universal one, meaning everyone that it talks to everyone and everyone can relate to it. So when to follow or not to follow, this is why I'm saying all this. It's not a question of follow or not follow. It's a question of being, of letting this happen. And somehow that you arrived to this point where you don't actually need to judge if it's good or not. It's just making something happen that didn't happen or didn't happen with that level of consciousness. When I looked for improvising in life outside of music or places where it's not that many places actually using improvising. I mean, everyone does, it's used everywhere, but very few claims it or wants to say. For sure, scientific people, searchers, all are improvising, but none will say Maybe because that's not what they look at as just a tool to go through. It's an element of things that if you put this with this at this time and at this time and at this time, you won't get exactly the same result. And maybe out of all these tests, well, one will show something that will help in the process, but it's not a final destination. So when to follow or not to follow? It may be a bit like in philosophy, it's more interesting the path through the question than actually the result or the statement. Statements are something solid you can maybe count on, but very soon the question is attacking the statement in itself. You can question the question, and the statement is just an element to go through with it. Also because the same statement is going to be... I'm going to take like parallels. I mean, like if you take bread or function of bread in food, you will have around the country many, many different versions of it, but the function will be the same. It will be this kind of, how you call it, slow sugar or whatever. Like spaghetti is a form of bread, like manioc is the same function, like when you make this pierogies, this potato, okay, all this is a function of human digestion in order to carry on living and get a certain energy and etc, etc, etc. Well, if you think of improvising as like as many tastes of breads and functions of breads and type of the same but a different product, it's maybe what I'm looking for. Improvising would be, for example, if I decide for 1 year to taste as many as possible same bread and see which ones are different, why, maybe go deeper and like look why. Maybe a same type of bread, exactly same type, same name, same ingredients, will have a total different taste if I'm in the mountain or I'm on the sea coast, if I'm in the north, in the east, in the west, in the south. You see, I'm not very good at answering, but I'll try. I think this is going to be the end of the number one file question.